guys, this is Sabrina from Phalias Creations, and today I wanted to make you guys these bracelets. I love these little bracelets because they're very quick for me to make, and I really do my very, very best at keeping it inexpensive. If you can see, they're just little bracelets, little charm on the end, and this doesn't have a tag, so this goes to the clasp like that. I like my little charm here, the Made with Love little charm. It goes around the bracelet like that. Okay guys, let's get a list of supplies and I'll be right back. Now for this project, what we need is 11 oz seed beads, and what I'm going to use is a clear little metal in the middle, 11 oz. Then what we need is some 8mm rondelles, and I chose some Swarovski, these like a light green bead rondelle. We need one clasp. And this is a very scientific for me to choose this clasp. And the way I choose the size is if they fit on this peg. This is very scientific, people. Is that. So that's the clasp for me. We also need two jump rings to attach that to. Now this bracelet has only one rondelle space, so let me show you one that has two. Is that so? You need two. I use 6mm rondelle spacers and two accent beads. So I have a little bead there in between the rondelle spacer and one there. And I haven't decided yet because this bracelet I am going to wear. So I got all my favorite colors, the green or light green, any shade of green I love. I love pinks and I love blue. So I have this, and this is a 4mm bicone, and it is a dark blue and it is fire polish. So honestly, I haven't decided if I'm going to use that one or this Swarovski. And I'm sorry, this blue was also Swarovski. Or this 8mm fire polish bead. Haven't decided that yet. And here's my rondelle spacers. And, like I said, I always like to use these little silver Made with Love. There at the end of there. Ain't that cute? Now for this bracelet, instead of using these seed beads there, I'm going to replace three of the seed beads with this light pink rondelle. And again, these are all my favorite colors. Now at the bottom there, you're going to see a list of supplies, and also what you will need. I have a number 13 beading needle. I try to keep them as big as I possibly can, and a arm's width of thread. And I know, guys, I'm using monofilament. I love monofilament. This is 8 pound. It rarely breaks. You know, I love this. Okay. Oh, and one more little tidbit that I do. I have two pair of reading glasses. I have one pair. That's a 2. And this is what I use to bead my thread with. And I have another pair, which is 150. And this is just for me to see. Because I do not like to, every little bitty detail I like to cover up. And this is one of my top selling bracelets. This little simple thing. Keep it very inexpensive. Okay. Okay, guys, so let's get started. Now, I'm going to start this on this end. Okay. It has the most little doodads for me, so I like to get it out of the way and off my beading map. So, I start with a 8mm rondelle. Then I need 7 beads, 7 seed beads. Now I'm going to replace 2 of the beads with a little pink rondelle. So I'm going to bead. Okay, guys, let me show you what I have. I don't know if you can hear that, but I'm sitting in my office, and across from my office, I have my sitting area, which is has like a bird sanctuary that they, from time to time, run us off. So every now and then, you're going to hear me make a loud noise to stop them from fighting. But right now, they seem to be feeding kind of quietly. But okay, so I have 3 seed beads, a 4mm rondelle, 3 seed beads, an 8mm rondelle, 3 seed beads, a 4mm rondelle, 3 seed beads, and an 8mm rondelle. And I'm going to take all of this, work it to the end of my thread, and I really like to leave, personally, I like to leave 6 inches. So funny, because at first, I did not like that. Did not like leaving so much thread. This is our first right angle weave. I'm going to tie a very loose knot. So our first set. Now, like I said, nice pretty colors. Now, like I said, I like to go ahead and do this end with the most little dangly stuff on it. Okay, so my thread is exiting out of the big rondelle, and I'm going to take it back through the seed bead closest to it. I'm going to go out of that. Give this a minute so it can focus. That sparkle is really confusing it. Okay, so now I'm going to add 6 seed beads. A rondelle spacer. Now, if you can remember, I have not decided which one I'm going to use, whether it's the clear bead or the blue bead. So let me put on a blue bead. I'm really hoping it's blue. I would love to have a touch of nice bright color. a rondelle spacer. Okay. And let's take a look. I don't know. I think that's just enough of a hint of blue for me to like it okay. So now I'm going to add. Now I'm going to add these seed beads right here. And that's 16 seed beads. Okay, now okay. I said 16. I made that this one a little shorter, so I'm going to add two more of the seed beads just to make sure it's going to be extended out long enough. I have a very small wrist though, so it's always kind of hard. So now I'm going to take it back through the rondelle, back through the 4 millimeter, and then back through the rondelle spacer, and I'm going to pull this pretty tight. And I like that. Just enough of a hint of a blue not to overpower it. And now let's add these seed beads back. And now this is how I'm going to attach it. I'm going to go through the seed bead right before the rondelle. The 8 millimeter rondelle, and I'm gonna go through it, that 8 millimeter rondelle, and go back out of the seed bead on the other side. Let's see if you can see that. Okay, now it's gonna. And this is a nice tug on that. So let's take a look. Ooh, nice and sparkly. Now, I'm going to go back through this a couple of times. But let me show you how I do this. So I'm going to go back through the beads, going back up through the rondelle spacers. Back up through that dark blue fire cone, through that rondelle spacer, and I'm just going to take a look see at that. Now I'm coming out of that rondelle spacer there at the top. Now, what I have learned with this is I like this loop to kind of be noticeable. I want it to be noticed that this is a nice round circle. So again, pull the thread as good as you can, and when I go through these beads, go through all of these beads. Instead of going back through the rondelle spacers and back down here, I am going to go through it, through the, sorry about that. I'm gonna go through the seed beads. And I'm gonna just go right back around through the seed beads in that, on this side, without going down that rondelle spacer. Now, if you don't like that to be a noticeable circle, then go back down through that rondelle spacer and back through there to reinforce it. But I like for it to be kind of a open loop like that. And go back through here. Go through and then now I can go down through the rondelle spacer, the 4 millimeter bicone and the rondelle spacer. And I had started going up by the end that this thread was coming out of. So I'm going to go down the other side, down through the seed beads on the other side. There we go. Nice and tight. And I'm going to go through that seed bead that's against that rondelle, through the rondelle, and I'm going to exit out of the rondelle before I get to that seed bead on the other side, because that's where my little tail is, and come out right there. And I'm going to use this opportunity, you see that, to tie my knot. I got one regular tie, and then now I'm going to double it, which means I'm going to take it back under twice. And pretty good pull. Test it. That is nice. Okay, now I'm going to take my little nippers. And nip off the thread, the little tail, because it is secured. And get as close in there as I possibly can. There we go. There we go. Now, I'm going to take my pliers. And guys, this will, I don't care if it loosen up or not, because it really needs to be tight. And I need to take my pliers. And now, because this is the end that I'm going to work on. So I need the round end of the clasp. I need one of the jump rings. And I need my made with love. It's funny, you take things for granted. A friend of mine had called me on the phone for help making a bracelet she was doing for her friend. And, you know, I didn't explain none of these steps clear enough, because I just assumed she knew what to how to do this. So let me take the time and explain this to you. These jump rings, the best way to do them, not only the best way to do it, the only way is to turn them. Okay? It weakens the jump ring if you pull them apart. And there's nothing more irritating than to keep doing that and it breaks in half. Okay? So now this jump ring is open. I'm going to put that in that little round circle that we made there with beads. I'm going to put my made with love and then the clasp. And then to tighten it up, no need, no fuss, and you twist it right back. Make sure they touch really well. There we go. Guess what? This end is complete. We don't have to go all the way back through it. Okay, let me get my tools off my table. So we're going to continue the right angle sets. So we're exiting out of the seed bead that's right next to the rondelle. Let me make sure that is correct. And we're going to go through the seed beads on the sides to get back to the 8mm rondelle so we can add on another unit. Now we're going to go in this rondelle, 8mm rondelle, and we're going to go out on the other side as the seed bead that's right against the 8mm rondelle. Now again, if you're going to do just seed beads on the side, like this bracelet, you would add on 6 seed beads in whatever color combination or whatever you want. But because I want to incorporate these little pink rondelles, I am going to add 2 seed beads a 4mm rondelle and then 3 seed beads or 11-0s. Now you see how there's 3 and only 2? Because there's already a seed bead that's right there, that's against that rondelle, coming out of that rondelle. So you don't want to add 3 because of that. So now you just need to add the 2, the rondelle, 4mm rondelle, and then the 11-0s. Now you're going to add an 8mm rondelle. And we're going to do opposite. So now we need to add 3 11-0s. A 4mm. And then 2 11-0s. Because again, to make that third rondelle, that third 11-0, the third 11-0 is already right there against the 8mm rondelle. So you're going to take it in, put the needle into that 11-0. Into that 11-0, through the rondelle, and through the 11-0 on the other side. So again, 11-0, rondelle, 11-0. Now to get back over to the 8mm rondelle, we're going to go through the 11-0, the 8mm, and the 11-0. Through the 8mm. And through the 11-0 on the other side. Nice little pool. I'm gonna do this a couple more times. Again, because we've added that 11-0 right there, we need to add just two more 11-0s. Two more 11-0s, a 4mm, and 3 11-0s. An 8mm. Three 11-0s. Okay, 4mm. And then only 2 11-0s. Only 2 11-0s, because that third 11-0 is going to be the 11-0 that's up against 8mm. So you're going to take it through the 8mm, through the 11-0, through the 8mm, and through the 11-0 on the other side. Guys, I spent so much time waiting for it to focus. There we go. I'm going to take it through. As we get to the end again, we're going to go through the side beads. Hey guys, one thing that I did not show you that I do from time to time is I go back and I reinforce these. And I'm going to show you real quick just how to do it. Again, just because some of you may not know how to go back through the thread. So I put on all the necessary beads that I need. I'm going to go back through the 11-0. The 8mm and the 11-0. Okay guys, so this is attached. Okay, so you know that this thread has went through there once, but we're going to go completely all the way around to reinforce it, to make it for the second time. And I am really not that hard on jewelry, because honestly, I'm here mostly making jewelry, so I don't wear it out and about. So I don't really reinforce something that I wear, but when I sell it, it is always reinforced. So again, I went all the way back around following the beads, following where the thread has already been. So if a thread hasn't been there before, don't make a new thread. So I'm just going to go right back through it and reinforce it with a second, and on one side, a third line of thread. There we go. Now I'm exiting back out of that 11-0 on the other side of that rondelle to start another set. Hello guys, so I am finishing up with my last right angle weave, and I'm going to show you how I'm going to attach the end. I am definitely not going to reinforce this last one, because of how many times I'm going to need to go through it to secure the end. Okay, so I'm exiting out the way I'm supposed to. I have the 11-0, the 8mm, and the 11-0. So I'm coming out of that 11-0. I'm going to attach 7 of the 11-0s. 7 11-0s. The rondelle spacer. The 4mm bicone. The rondelle spacer. And I'm going to attach 18 11-0s. So we have on the end coming out of that the 11-0, we have 7 11-0s, the rondelle spacer, the 4mm bicone, the rondelle spacer, and then 18 11-0s. And I'm going to take this, drop down all of them 11-0s, take it through the rondelle spacer, the 4mm, and the rondelle spacer. Add on them 7 11-0s. And now, after you get the 7 11-0s, I'm going to pull it tight and go through the 11-0 on the other side, the 8mm, and then the 11-0 on the other side. See that? And go through there and pull it pretty tight. Now, I'm pulling it, so I'm going to go up top and go and reinforce this end. So I'm going to go through the 11-0s, through the rondelle spacers, the 4mm, through all of that. Through the 11-0s up top there in that circle. Pull that good and tight. Keep going around. And remember, for me, I like for it to be, to have more of a defined circle down here toward the end, right there. So, when I go through here, so let's continue around. And to make sure my circle is nice and defined, a second, this has gotten a little tight. Go down through here, and right at that spacer, circle back. This is going to make it look more like a nice space up through there. Down through the rondelle spacer, the beads, and back to the other side. There we go. Back down to there. I'm going to flip it now. Go through here. And a good pull. There we go. Now we need to make a knot. The best way to make a knot is to do it against the 8mm rondelles. Anywhere else, and you're going to distort the shape of this bracelet. Okay, so I'm going to go down through here and come out of that end of the rondelle. And this is where my first knot is going to be. This is really funny about these knots, and this is the way this goes, is if you're coming down through this way, this knot should go under. I'm gonna do one more under. Okay, oh, and I untied it. Okay, under. And one more under, and I'm going to again make sure that's against that 8mm rondelle, and I'm going to pull. I'm going to go through this 11-0 and go all the way back down so I can be back against this 8mm. Now, I reinforced mine. So when you get in there, it should be about 2 or 3 loops of thread. And I'm going to try to... You know, the thing about this is, if you don't use the monofilament, you're going to end up tearing your thread. And that's why I love monofilament. So I'm going to go down until I snag it. Okay, until I snag one of the thread pieces on monofilament. You see that? I'm going to go through, not all the way, and will leave me enough for my final knot. And my final knot, go in it once and in it a second time and tie it. I'm going to hold it and I'm going to pull it. I'm going to take my little nippers, my nipper uppers, when I find it. Give me 1 second, guys. There we go. And I'm just going to nip it as close as I can. There we go. That's nip. That part is done. So now what we need to attach the jump ring and the other end of the clasp. And again, take it. Sorry about that. And I'm going to pull it. Twist it, put it in jump ring. Okay, there we go. That's in there. And then that. Okay, then we're going to twist it back. Make sure it connects and pretty good. There we go. And there is my bracelet. Can barely kind of see that, the pink in that, but I can see it. You see the little touch of blue? Let me put it on real quick. Okay, there we go. Very, very nice, guys. I really, really love it. That little hint of blue, I love that. I didn't want it to be kind of all in your face, but I want it to be just a small little detail of it. There we go. And, you know, I know it's a pretty bracelet, but I do like to wear this side up. I really do, but there we go. And there's the bracelet. Pretty, pretty thing. Thank you guys so much for watching. You guys have a great, great day.